obviously walked out with medication that healed my liver. I did not want to have a transplant. I'm still currently an ongoing patient, but it's certainly the place to be if you have a sick child or if you are a patient. I mean, I give all the glory to the doctors and nurses here at Children's, and it's truly a special place to be.
How do you think that that impacted your goals and dreams and just how you looked
at it? It impacted my life in so many ways. So I'm involved in the Miss America organization, and the Miss America organization's platform is Children's Miracle Network. And when I got involved, I had no idea. And so it just went hand in hand that that so happened to be my platform. And now it's kind of evolved into liver health and teaching people how to maintain a healthy liver. But I will always be an advocate for children's healthcare, Children's Miracle Network hospitals, CHOA, simply because of my experience with Children's Miracle Network. Like I said, I just can't say enough great things about this hospital, and it's truly a full circle moment to be, like I said, sitting here being interviewed. When I sat in this room with Ed Sheeran 10 years ago, interviewing him, and it's really a bittersweet moment. And like I said, my platform is called Love Your Liver, Love Yourself, and it's all about teaching people how to maintain a healthy liver, but also I'm a huge advocate for Children's and raising funds for Children's.
So what made you want to get into politics?
Oh goodness, so actually my mother was Miss Georgia USA 1985.
Wow!
Oh no.
She went on to be Mrs. Georgia in 2005, and I was 5 years old, and I really wanted to be in pageants when I was young, but my mom actually told me you had to be married to compete in pageants, just because she really wanted me to hone it as my own and you know, take the reins and say, this is something that I wanted to do. She wanted me to do this as something that I personally wanted to do instead of just kind of following in her footsteps, so to speak. And so I started off in the Little Miss Cobb County talent competition. Actually, I never won it, but I went on to just spur of the moment compete in the Miss Cobb County junior teen pageant, and I was the youngest girl to compete, and I won. It was like spur of the moment. Didn't have a dress. A friend brought me a dress to wear. My mom actually was a pageant coach at the time and coaching, you know, multiple different girls that were competing, and I begged her to do it, and she finally, I just think, to get me to be quiet a little bit, was just like, okay, just go do it. And so that kind of evolved into the Miss Cobb County Board reaching out to me and asking me to be Miss Cobb County's Outstanding Teen in 2016 and then 2018, and now I am sitting here as Miss Cobb, which that's another full circle moment that I could go on and on about. But the main reason I compete in the Miss America organization is because of the scholarships. Over the past 6 years of competing, I placed, I think we did the math the other day, it was like $23,000 towards my education.
Wow.
Yeah, so as Miss Cobb, I win $10,650 towards my education, and another incredible part of MAO is each girl has a social impact initiative, which I've already expressed that mine is Love Your Liver, Love Yourself, and then the cherry on top of that is I'm also an advocate for Children's.
Wow, that's so impressive. So what is one of your other roles or responsibilities that people would be surprised to know?
Roles or responsibilities. Well, I'm a full-time college student.
That's a big role right there. Say no more.
I know that y'all all understand that. I attend Middle Tennessee State University in Murfreesboro, Tennessee. And let me tell you, being Miss Cobb and being a full-time college student and making sure I have great grades and being a full-time title holder is definitely a juggling act. You can ask my mom, I can come home every single weekend from Murfreesboro, Tennessee, which is about a 3-hour drive from where I live, and I have probably put, in less than a year, I put 22,000 miles in my car. Yeah.
Lots of road.
And I haven't even had my car for a year, so I definitely am always on the road, always busy, but I am so passionate about this, and I wouldn't be doing it if it wasn't something that I was, like I said, incredibly passionate about, and I mean, that's just something that's you know, super special, I guess, about me. But also, another fun fact about myself, my brother is also a miracle child. He, right before we graduated high school, we're kind of like twins through adoption, so to speak. We're both adopted, but we're around the same age. And today is actually his 21st birthday. But he was diagnosed with testicular cancer, and so it was stressful on behalf of my mom that she had already had a child go through a chronic liver disease, and now she had a child experience testicular cancer, but he's cancer-free, and we give all the glory to Children's. They are incredible. I just, like I said, I can't say enough great things about them.
So good.